What's going on, guys? Rivero here. Welcome to another episode in our Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess Let's Play series. I'm kind of sick, as you can hear in just a sec. Yeah, it's horrible. But I mean, whatever. We're gonna power through it. So, last episode we did some glitching fun. Seems like we're doing a lot of glitches lately. But oh well. If you need any lantern oil, you can go ahead and get it here. I'm gonna do it just because I need a little bit. And I'd prefer it to be completely full. So why not? Let's fill out our lantern. And let's go on ahead now. Oh, and by the way, you can see that this painting is the Zora princess that died. The mother of Prince Rallus, so that's kind of weird. But here we are, the first room, technically, or the second room. Sorry, I have sickness. Me too! Come closer. Is close enough? You cute little human. Husband told me you come. You want to look at mirror, My husband found it, but it's pretty thing, But since I get mirror, I get sick, and then bad monsters appear. So many bad things happen since mirror. So we lock bedroom on third floor, where it hangs, Wait, I'll tell you where key is. So she's the one who gives us the map in this dungeon. Or house, more like. Fever makes head blurry, but I'd probably hear in the room marked by this symbol. So, right there's. Apparently I can't zoom in, but you'll see it in a sec. But right now, can't even get up. Would you bring it to me? Start with door right there. So we can go through this door right here. Let me go ahead and show on the map. Right over there. Yeah, there it is. So we're going to that. And this is the first room we start in. Or on our journey to find the key, I guess. And it's yet, you! Wife look bad, Not healthy since mirror. So I make soup for her. Fish from Zora Village are most nutritious. You tired, You have some, it give you energy. No thanks, I got enough. In my bottles. Oh, I guess that we already had lantern oil, huh? You know what? We're just gonna see if we can use it up right now. Because there's something useful here in a sec that we can go ahead and get. And considering we only have three hearts, it'll be kind of useful. So we take some soup in our bottle. And it's called Simple Soup. It replenishes two hearts. And right now, two hearts are better than no hearts, and we're just gonna keep doing this for a second. And you probably also heard that the Uku is nearby. So we'll go ahead and get him after this. One more, since it's not really that useful, we'll go ahead and not just like fill it up for another heart. But if we do lose a heart, we'll go ahead and drink it. So over here is the Uku, and maybe even a heart in one of these pots. So here we go, the Uku again, this time right at the beginning of the dungeon, unlike the sand one. So yay, now I save and quit and I respawn back at the same door. That's useful. I never really actually realized that. I thought he took you back to the dungeon, just only at the beginning. So like you could go to the sand temple after being at like Ordon, just at the beginning. But nope, it's even better. None of these pots have hearts, that was lame. Okay, let's continue to go to the boss key. So this place seems pretty straightforward so far. We're already like right next to the key if we just have to do a few more things. Such as block pushing puzzles. These wouldn't be so bad if there wasn't a cutscene for every single time you pushed a block. Otherwise, it's nice and dandy. I was holding forward, not to the right. It lied. Okay, I think I might have messed this up. Hopefully pushing this here doesn't completely destroy it. Or make it completely difficult. Get over here! Roll the rock. The block. The block rock. Yeah, because I don't think I can pull this. Nope. Dang it. We're doing it the long way, I guess. Dang it. Why is it... I'm holding forward, but it's either turning left or right. Gosh dang it, this doesn't make any sense. Stupid physics. Don't understand. We will get something that'll actually make this a lot quicker too, though, so be excited for that. Because cutscenes for pushing a block. How nice. Go forward. There we go. And two more pushes. This one, and then we get this block on this pressure plate. I remember one of my friends had a lot of trouble with this puzzle, and I had to actually, like, come over to their house to do it for them, because they just didn't know how to do it. Don't know how they didn't know how to do it. They were probably the age I am now, so, I mean, come on. It's, like, the easiest thing ever. So, can't go anywhere, it seems, but in reality, there's a place we can dig right here, which... remember the scent trail that we had to follow? How it went in a place we had to dig? How did Yetta get through there? He is enormous! And you can't tell me he hopped over because the smell literally went down into the ground. I don't know, it's weird. We got this nice cutscene of the outside area. We saw the dungeon, or the boss key dungeon area. So we already know where the boss is. And we got a few wolves. They're not too difficult. We're gonna ignore them and dig right here because there's actually a chest hidden into the snow. And it holds a key, which is actually really useful. Then there's a chest over here that's not diggable. It just, you can open it right now. Which is 20 rupees, sweet. And now... Okay, here we go. Now we can go ahead and turn into human and go through this door. To be on the other side of that ice cube that we saw. Right? Yeah, there's an ice cube there. I want to say this will kill him in one hit, but I'm pretty positive it doesn't. Doing the final strike. Oh man, it actually works. But it's also dangerous. I guess we can use that potion here in a second. Oh yeah, and that happens too. They're like, you know what, we're just gonna bam. And then here we go, final attack in a second here. I hate these guys. There we go. Because even if you jump attack, sometimes you'll like end up getting too close and freeze again. I already got the door that had the locked place. Oh, actually, you could probably use that on the door above to get farther, huh? Well, we're not going to break the game that much. You can do that on your own time. I think the best way to do this is just spin attack. Probably not, but that's how I do it. So why not? I didn't get hit at all. It worked. My tactics never fail me. Looks like this is the only way to go. So what were those three single spinny ice cube guys guarding? Oh, there's the boss key, apparently. And that's exactly where the flag goes, so I guess we're already there. Huh. Okay. Yeah, I don't know where those guys came from. That's kind of weird. Whoa. We like, ouch, no, dang it. You weren't supposed to do that. Let's just wail on this guy. Dang it. That one keeps attacking me. These guys also suck. I don't like these guys either. I just attack them until they die. Because if you wait too long, then they get their spear again, and it practically gives them full health again. Okay, now that we've gotten through here, we can go ahead and collect the boss key, but it's weird because it's not a boss chest. Isn't that weird? And we got the Ordon pumpkin. Yep. We got a pumpkin. What's this? Isn't it right? Want to go back and try to get her to remember where the key is? Yep. Why not? There's the desert place, the last place that we were at. Grotto's something. Ruins? I don't know. So I guess we're going back to ask her where the next thing is. We actually can get a shortcut here too, which is pretty useful. If I can find where the shortcut is, I might have to go up here. Yep, here we go. So there's a block right here we can push. I think. Maybe not. Maybe I was lying. I bet I lied to you. How do you feel? Well, I'm about to prove you wrong, because we're gonna get it anyways. Just kidding, you still can't get it, I'm pretty sure. Yep, yeah. Trust me, I've tried a long time, and I couldn't ever figure it out. Pretty much impossible. Okay, we're gonna go this way. And go back to Yetta! Let's see what happens if we try to dodge him. Oh, actually, no. This is the faster way. Let's just talk to him now. What flavor? Oh! Pumpkin! You have pumpkin, huh? He literally shoves us, and the pumpkin pops out. Dude, didn't even cut it or anything, but it just makes the soup perfect. Thanks, You taste if you want. So, apparently none of our other items fall when he pushes up, but just the pumpkin. Pretty weird. Now, if we actually get the soup, so before it was 2 hearts, and now it's actually called good soup, and it's 4 hearts. So let's drink this and refill it once more for later, just in case. Apparently they thought this dungeon was really hard, or they just put this in because they thought it was cool. And it is a pretty good idea, because once the soup is fully finished, it helps revive the girl over here, I guess. Is she human? She doesn't look human. I guess she does. I don't know, your eyes are like really big. What, pumpkin? But why there? No good. Where I leave it? Maybe in that room. So now we're going to a different room that might have the boss key. Go to the room marked by a symbol. Where? I don't see it. Oh, is that? Oh, okay, it's in the very top room right there. Do you see it? It's up there. Okay. Check room I marked on map. And then she opens the door for us, somehow. She probably has, like, some sort of controller under there, using her feet or something else that's under there. And now let's continue. See what's on the other side of this snowy outside area. More wolves, which we shall attack with our wolf form. Attack! Yeah, killed him, one shot. There's something to dig here. We dig it once, and then twice, and then 3 times, and there's a chest. How nice. Well, that was a weird noise. And another key. It's almost like this other side, but different slightly. Okay, so that's the entrance to that door. What's in this room? Because there's no place that's locked here, so might as well just see what's here now. Let's go through the door! And... yeah, this room. So this is one of the rooms we actually ended up seeing, but it was blocked off by a thing of ice, so I guess now we can go ahead and see it. But first we gotta kill these guys. Dang it! See, that's what I mean by, like, you jump attack and it, like, messes with you. Where'd you go? Ah! That wasn't fair, he got me behind the corner. Okay, let's grab this cannonball thing right here. We're running across with it, gotta dodge the enemies. Oh man, it's a crazy game, you gotta watch out, cause they're going so fast. Okay, this might actually be more difficult. Nope, we still did it. Easy as pie. Now, there's 2 ways we can shoot this. For now, we'll just shoot it this way, cause it's already in that place. Maybe it'll kill those guys. Nope. I wish. Got him! And... nope, he's out of here. Okay, over on this side, when you blow up this area, there's a chest! With bombs, actually, that's pretty useful. We actually could use those. Sweet! Now we're gonna go ahead and get the cannonball back, somehow unharmed at all from going straight into ice. That apparently has the ability to freeze us. That doesn't really make any sense when you think about it. How the heck is the ice freezing you just from touching it? Is it magical ice? I don't know. Well, who cares? We'll just go ahead and break it this way, because apparently rock breaks ice, and not bone and flesh, I guess. Okay. That's frozen. It's kind of painful. Man, there's a chest over there, and we can't get it yet. Lame. What's also lame is the fact that I keep getting frozen. So now that we've gotten to this door, we've already gotten all the things that are in there due to the glitch, so you can go ahead and just get the chest in there. Not too difficult. I'm sure you can do that without me showing you. So now we're gonna go ahead and go to this locked door, because we got the key! So what's this area have in store for us? Cannonballs! Everywhere! You go up, don't go up that ladder, there's a monster up there that'll just knock you straight off. So we have this weird lever thingy that we can put a cannonball on. And just so you know, nothing is available over on that side either, the other side that we looked at. Because there's no way, it's impossible to get over. Now that we've gotten a cannonball on this side, you probably noticed that there was a cannon just over here. Go, cannonball! We're gonna just turn it a wolf. Though it probably would have been faster just to turn, or just to keep going. Oh well. It can't all be that easy. Okay, let's shoot another one. I should just put my face right in front of him and be like, hello? Hello, what's going on in here? More bombs, that's kind of dumb. I don't really know why they're just giving you bombs after you use one bomb. And I don't know. It's weird. Oh well. So we got a monster over here. I haven't really paid too much attention to it. We did see one last episode. They shoot ice out of their mouths, and we haven't been able to attack them with anything. But with this cannonball thingy, we can. And we get a cutscene, so we can't stand in front of the cannon. Dang it! So once you do kill those guys, they will turn into three of these small things. Luckily, the cannonball does kill one of them. So it's a little nice. But we're just gonna ignore those guys, because who cares about them? They're just weird things. We got this interesting hallway. We got, like, some spears, a cannon, a, like, platform, another cannon, some boxes, these cool armor statues. So look at this one. Look at him. Look at him. He's normal. Nothing weird. And then you'll already know that one's not the right one. So the door locks. And we hear this noise behind us. Bam! Yep, that one statue apparently wasn't a statue. So you'll be like, oh, okay, I guess he just stood there and managed to not move at all. But wait till we look behind him. You'll realize something. I think that's like the first boss, or mini-boss, that's ever like showed itself without showing you like directly after like its weakness. Because the weakness of this guy is his tail, which the statue obviously doesn't have. It had like a armored butt. Okay. I just kind of ignore the cannonball. As long as you have enough health, who cares? You can get him without losing too much health. And there we go. It wasn't too extreme, it was pretty easy. And there we go, the mini boss here is finished. And we got the cool little swing taunt thing. All of him has disappeared except for his ball and chain. This is kinda cool how they did this, how it just like lays here and you get to pick it up. There's no chest or anything, it's just like, there you go. You earned it. So, this one's pretty cool. You got like, you go swing, 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 and then you throw it, and it breaks things. Such as ice, those monsters, other monsters, anything that's ice, yeah. Or just barrels, which have money in them. Or these statues. And one of them actually has this guy, for one. And you break this, no, not that guy. By the way, if you keep holding the thing, you can, like, constantly swing it and it, like, breaks it without having to, like, throw it once or twice. I didn't ever know that until, like, recently. One of these statues actually has something useful in it. And of course, I think we chose the last one. Or it's just not here. Huh, I thought there was money in one of them. Guess not. Huh. Well, we come in here, and we got not the boss key again, but Ordon goat cheese. They really must like Ordon. Aw, food again? Yeah, I had a bad feeling about this. She didn't seem very sure of herself. Oh well, let's head back and hope she had some other brilliant idea. Man, sassy. But yes, it is kind of annoying that we have to go find food and not the boss key. Though it does make an interesting boss, or dungeon. We kind of walked through that cannonball, that was weird. Oh yeah, now that we have the wrecking ball, we can go ahead and just get rid of this ice barrier that we had before, and let all the wolves in, that's always nice. Dang, we can use it. Is it as a shield? I think you can even attack them. Let's see, watch this. Yeah, this is literally like a giant shield. Okay, sort of. Okay, get back on land, Link, before they attack you again. Okay. And let's destroy this ice. Where do we want to go this time? I guess we'll just go back the way we came. Sure. Ugh. This is the only part I hate, the snow right here that's around the cannonball. And then the fact that you can't open these stupid doors as a wolf. What kind of sense does that make? Minda has a giant arm. I'm sure she can use that. Like, come on. No, this is the wrong way. Dang it! Mirrored version got me all mixed up still. I'm trying my best, but sometimes it's difficult. We're going through this door instead, I guess. And we can actually just go through this window and break this ice now that we have the wrecking ball. So we got a bunch of shortcuts that we've just made. And we can go through this place, which I think has the block puzzles in it. So we'll go ahead and do this next, where we can break open this, as well as unfreeze that somehow, because for the frozen part on the back, somehow that falls off after you get the first part. Now, this part takes a bit, so we're just gonna get it over with now, so we don't have to have to do that in the next episode, and start off the episode with a boring thing like this. All you have to do is keep towering these blocks into the middle until it reaches the middle, I guess. Oh, and you don't have to do that extra push I just did. Oops. So it seems just one more, and we'll get one on the thing. So this is the part where I can understand if you get stuck on. You pull this one behind it, and this one doesn't slide back here or anything, so it just stays there. See, I went with, like, how physics work, you know? Because, like, I was like, well, that doesn't make sense. If I push this here, this block's gonna slide with it down to this part. But nope, once you slide this block over to that one, it doesn't move. Newton's law is a lie. It's kind of funny, because that's what we've been learning in science. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna push this one and put it on the other one so that all the doors are open. Makes it easy on ourselves. Shortcuts everywhere. Let's get this one here. Push it one more time to the right. And all the doors are unlocked. Yay! And let's go ahead and go talk to Yetta, because I'm sure he'll love to take the cheese from us. So, hey Yetta, guess what I got? Needs more punch. What? Good smell! What do you have? Hey, that was mine. Perfect ingredient, huh? Come on, you didn't even cut the cheese. But, little more time on fire, it becomes gourmet soup. Here, taste, Okay, let's have a taste. So, it used to be good soup with four hearts. Now what is it? It is superb soup, which replenishes 8 hearts. And it's kind of weird because it's still like the fish face. It's kind of creepy. But whatever. We're not picky, apparently. Let's talk to this person one more time. I think I remember, We put Kiri in nearby rooms, so not forgetting. How I forget, embarrassing, huh? See here, place marked by symbol, top right. As you can see, probably, hopefully, right up there. It there, it must be, you look for me. This one's the longest taking one, so next time on the Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, we are going to go through this room and see what's on ahead. See you guys then.